Do you know what this is? Looks a bit like a small Xbox 360, right? Well, it's not a console, but it is an add-on to the 360. It's the Xbox 360 HD DVD player. In typical Xbox fashion, the name rolls right off the tongue and into a ditch. Though to be fair, like, what else are they gonna call it, right? In contrast to today's world where we have diskless iterations of consoles, like the Xbox One Digital Edition, the Xbox Series X, and the PS5 Digital Edition, the HD DVD player for the Xbox 360 does the opposite and adds an extra optical drive to the system. This video is part of a series called Useless But Interesting, and yes, the title is perhaps a bit harsh, but it's about products that don't have much use today, but still have some interesting points about them. This thing really didn't age well. Not only is it cumbersome to have an extra box beside your box, but the media it promises to play back is now obsolete, and has been now for over a decade. Though I will give it credit for being a cheap way to watch movies, as actual HD DVD films were, as you can imagine, really cheap after the format was discontinued. That whole era of 7th gen consoles, which started in the mid-2000s, is really interesting. It bridged two different eras in a multitude of fields. Back then, we had CRT and flat screens at the same time. Analog and digital outputs on the same console were normal. Digital distribution started becoming a normal thing with games and DLC. For the first time, we also saw widespread updates and patches for games on consoles. Streaming video gained more and more importance, with YouTube becoming more popular, and Netflix, the well-known DVD by mail rental service, started getting into the streaming business as well. And this was also the era where DVD started to not exactly cut it anymore, as video games needed more space and movies and shows needed an HD alternative. And that brought on the format war, which was between HD DVD and Blu-ray. Blu-ray is widely considered to be Sony's format, though that's not entirely true. Other companies like Panasonic and Philips, for example, are involved there, but it is true that Sony was the primary creator. That's also why Blu-ray drives came standard in PS3s. In November 2006, Microsoft launched the HD DVD add-on to augment the 360's media capabilities. It, however, did not have a long life, as it was discontinued in February 2008, so it didn't even last 2 years. The reason for that is on February 19, 2008, Toshiba, the main force behind HD DVD, announced that they would drop the format and stop production of HD DVD players. That automatically meant that Blu-ray was victorious. I have an Xbox 360 HD DVD player in box, so let's take a look. I bought it used from the US. I do wonder if this may have been a Canadian unit, because there's French, and there's a Canadian age rating for the included movie. So maybe it migrated to the States somehow and now it's back in Canada after I bought it? Possibly. Or maybe the labeling was identical for both countries, I'm not really entirely sure on that. As you can see, the branding matches that of the original 360 console. The Slim was still several years away. There's some blurbs on some features and benefits, and one of the sides lists the contents. It says it comes with an HD DVD player, so that's a good start. A USB cable, which apparently creates one simple and powerful connection, which is interesting. It's just a cable, I don't know why you have to play it up so much. There's also an AC adapter and an installation disk. For some reason, the barcode's been cut out, and I have a theory on that, which we'll get to later. The box with everything in it is quite heavy for its size. There is a compartment on the lid on the inside there. This bundle shipped with King Kong when new, but it wasn't included when I bought it, but I'm guessing this is where it would go. Now there's only the manual in it. But now is when things start to get interesting. From looking at the box, it's obviously not new since there's scuffs and dents, not to mention the movie is missing and the manual is a bit bent. But everything else seems to be untouched. A bit of a contrast there. There's the install disc, underneath is the actual HD DVD player, and at the bottom we have the cables and the remote. Everything is completely factory fresh here. The player looks spotless and even had the original sticker on the front. It wasn't reapplied, I made sure to look if there was like any dust or stuff on the adhesive side, but there isn't. It's interesting that this little pamphlet matches the UI the Xbox 360 had back in the day. Some of you may not even have experienced the original Blades style interface. Later on they changed it to the Windows 8 style rectangles and squares. The remote has its original battery still sealed in, and the cables haven't been used either. You can see how neatly everything is folded, and there's a little seal with some instructions, which have never been removed. I wonder if this unit was returned, which could explain the barcode being removed. Perhaps what happened was that someone bought one of these just as the discontinuation of HD DVD was announced. Not sure where the movie ended up though. Here you can see the HD DVD player next to a 360. The styling certainly matches. White was the only color available, though there were black Xboxes, you know, like the Elite Edition, but they didn't go for any other colors when it comes to the player. The player can sit vertically, even though it doesn't have rubber feet on the side. I checked the manual just to confirm. If you have it vertically though, you gotta be careful because if you press the eject button, the unit can easily slide back. So that's not really been designed well. That being said, I do really like the original 360 design, and I think these two pieces of hardware still look really nice and modern, for the most part anyways. Unfortunately, this 360 doesn't work, but I do have a working slim model we can try the player on. Thankfully, the player works with every iteration of the 360. Setup is really simple. In case you didn't look at the manual, one of the cables will remind you to install the software before connecting the player, or at least before using it, I'm not sure which one. I just left it disconnected. You launch the install disk like you would a game. Amusingly, the image is stretched. There's something ironic about having the install process of an HD device be in 4x3. It tells you to plug all the cables in, that's fairly easy, AC adapter and then a USB cable from the player to the console. Before you know it, it's over. At first, I wasn't exactly sure how to play anything off of the player, but if you go to the apps, you'll see the HD DVD application listed. Because of HDCP, I can't show you anything, not to mention it'd be probably, you know, I'd get a copyright strike or something on YouTube here. If you want a third reason, I don't have any HD DVDs. Not that it matters for this video. Thankfully, they are cheap, and I kind of do want to have, like, you know, maybe a few here and there just for collecting reasons. So maybe I'll pick something up that I like or perhaps have been interested in checking out. The player can not only play HD DVD discs, but also regular DVDs too. Games do not work on the player. The Xbox won't say that there's a game in there, and opening the HD DVD app does nothing except give you an error message. The player also acts as, or rather it accepts the Wi-Fi adapter, just so you know. One thing that is worth mentioning too is the remote. It's great, it feels quite high quality, and it even lights up when you press a button. The buttons are a bit high and they rock side to side a bit, but it's still pretty good. Too bad it doesn't work with the new Series X. So that's the Xbox 360 HD DVD player. While not particularly useful for most people these days, it's still an interesting device that encapsulates a specific time and era. It's very much a product of its age. I'm quite happy to have one in my collection. I hope you found that interesting. I'd love to know if any of you viewers actually have one of these and if you've picked one up before or after discontinuation. Like always, thank you to everyone who supports the channel, whether you're watching the videos or even contributing on Patreon. You get some benefits as a patron like behind-the-scenes news and early access to videos. You can check that out on patreon.com/YSN. Thanks for watching and I'll see you again in the next video.